widely known that regular exercise has many benefits. Depending upon what you do and the intensity of it, exercise can be good for your heart and lungs, your muscular and nervous systems. It can even be good for your mental health. Hello, my name is Kevin Gard, and I'm a doctor of physical therapy at Drexel University. During these times of social distancing, I want to share with you some practical tips about how you can incorporate exercise into your regular routine without the need for a lot of equipment or a gym. The first thing you need to do is make exercise a priority, including scheduling it throughout your regular day, just like you would any important meeting. If you schedule your exercise and stick to your schedule, you'll be more likely to do it. Find a regular time of the day when you enjoy exercising. Perhaps that's at the beginning of the day before your workday starts, or maybe you need a break in the middle of your workday. Either way, find a time that'll work for you, put it on your schedule, and then stick to that schedule so that you're exercising every single day. All exercise programs should try and target three main areas. The first is increasing your heart rate, the second is doing some resistance training, and the third is stretching. You don't need to do all three of these each day. In fact, you shouldn't. You should mix them up from day to day so that it makes the exercise more interesting. The important thing is that you're doing something every day for 20 to 30 minutes. To increase your heart rate, you can do some things like taking a walk, going for a run, or even riding a bike. If you don't have access to that type of thing, you could do simple things like doing jumping jacks or jumping rope. If you're gonna walk or ride a bike or run, try and aim for doing that for 20 to 30 minutes. If you're gonna do jumping jacks or jump a rope, try instead doing 2 to 3 sets of 10 to 15 repetitions. A good guideline on intensity of exercise with this is that you should be able to carry on a conversation while you're performing those exercises. If you're gasping for breath, then you are doing them at too intense of a level and you should make them easier. For resistance training, use your body weight as well as items around your home for resistance. Suggested exercise could include push-ups, tricep dips, step-ups, lunges, squats, or heel raises to incorporate various portions of your body. You can make things more difficult if needed by holding an object or increasing the number of repetitions you do. Objects that you could use around your home could be anything that weighs something. For example, you could use an object like, well, that's probably a little too heavy, perhaps something like this or something similar. So for example, if you were going to do step-ups with something like this, you could hold on to the object and then do your step-up and do them repeatedly holding this object. As you'll notice with this step too, I'm stepping up on the highest part of this wall. I could do the lower part of the wall to make it easier as well. Creating those variations in your exercise program will increase the intensity or decrease the intensity and make it challenging for you. Okay. The nice thing about resistance exercise too is if you do them rapid enough or change between them quickly enough, it'll help elevate your heart rate and you'll get double benefit from those. Finally, to stretch, there are many stretching programs that you can find online or even yoga programs that you can find online that are very good about leading you through a full body stretch. The things to remember here is that you should be doing all motions in a very slow and controlled manner, and they should never cause pain. The objective with these types of exercises, with the stretching exercises, is to increase the range of motion around your joints as well as increase the flexibility of the muscles. With any of these forms of exercise, especially if you're new to exercise, make sure you start slowly and increase gradually. Often people, when they start exercising, they try and do things too intensely or with too much intensity, and then they develop soreness or even an injury which prevents them from exercising. The first day you exercise, it should be relatively easy so that you're not too sore and that you can continue to exercise day after day. The last suggestions I'll leave you with is to have fun with your exercise program. There is no need to make exercise torture. Enjoy the opportunity to get outside and move around and take pride in your progress over time. I hope you found these suggestions to be helpful. Exercise every day and go Dragons.